Hi everyone. So today I'm going to talk to you about different stuff. The key one is the just to show you how starting from blockchain, there is a wonderful opportunity for the energy sector. As I mentioned here, just to introduce myself, I'm an engineer. I've done an MBA, I've done psychology, and I did many stuff in my life. Among them, doing an attempt on Mount Everest. Also, we share with William a kind of a track record in the internet. I began internet in 1982, having my first site in 1983, and also getting the opportunity because of Alta Vista to meet Larry Page, to meet Jeff Bezos when he launched his Amazon in France and all of that. So I'm doing, you will see, a lot of comparison with the internet, and I do agree that the fact that we are living probably in a 10-year period what we've seen over the internet in 25 years. So it's a wide open world. I can tell you that in 1984, I was working for McKinsey and Company. I was telling people, you know, that's what we can do in terms of transaction, in terms of whatever chat, whatever research and all of that. Alta Vista just came in around 1985. It was just amazing for everyone and a lot of pushback at that time. So blockchain right now is exactly the same. And when I meet people, I'm doing a bit of evangelization in France, but I choose not to do it, you know, just over the counter for everyone, just to get specialized on the energy sector, because energy is kind of very important in terms of PIB, in terms of gross national product, around between 5% and 10%. This is a quick catch-up. I'm talking about blockchain 1.0 and blockchain 2.0, which has been brought in by Ethereum. No big need. I'm going to give some illustration. We are kind of running out of time. No big need to go too deep in detail here. What I want to show you also is there is a site which can be useful for William here also, is the Blockchain Angel, which has done a kind of neat track record of all of the startup which has been launched over the last year and a half. And so you've got something like 1,200 which has been launched. And among them, you've got the split. So that may be of some use if you want to launch a startup to see the intensity of the competition, you know, in each of the field. What I just wanted to point out here is the fact that energy and utilities account only for 1.2. So probably around 12, let's say 15 companies. I launched a site in French, which is Observatoire des Blockchains de l'Énergie. It's observatoire-blockchains.com, and you will find all of the information on that, plus something like 100 links. So this is pretty interesting because energy hasn't been well treated till now. If you look at the whole story of the energy, it all began, in fact, for the blockchain with someone called Marta. She lives in Brooklyn 2 years ago. She began to do production of PV, of photovoltaic electricity, on top of one of the building. After that, you know, some others she gave or sold the electricity to some other people all around, and the other began to do the same. You may imagine all the conflicts that you have on how much I have produced, how much I've been consumed, and all of that. And blockchain appears to be, you know, the ideal solution at the, appeared to be the ideal solution at that time. So that was, I would say, kind of the foundation of the mindset of the application of blockchain to the energy sector. 1 year ago, there was another thinking in France done by Bouygues, and that's in the very nice city underneath here is Lyon, and the confluence, the meeting of the Saône and the Rhône and the Saône is here. And Bouygues had the idea to do that and to put a photovoltaic on top of the building. So they began to think about that, and I was part of the project to look at the blockchain, to just blockchain the production of the electricity on top of it, and then blockchain the electricity at consumed and used at each of the level of the building. Obviously here, when you work with a national company like EDF in France, you don't have, you know, any need of blockchain. As soon as you got a private investor or private real estate company, you do need a trustless solution. So a demonstrator was presented and a very neat discussion with Satya Nadella, the head of Microsoft at that time. There is a big difference between energy with between crypto kilowatt-hour here, kilowatt-hour as I as we called it, and the Bitcoin, is that every time you take a Bitcoin, you know, from one place to another all around the world, the value of the Bitcoin hasn't changed. I would say just by the transfer of the information, it's very highly different. With the crypto kilowatt-hour, every time you go from one building to another, every time you store the crypto kilowatt-hour, you're gonna lose money. You're gonna lose the value of the kilowatt-hour itself. So that's where Ethereum is very interesting, because of the smart contracts. You can have some rules which are embedded directly in the smart contracts in the way to handle it or store it. There is another way which is very interesting that we are testing currently, is that the fact when you make crypto kilowatt-hour, you may decide the destination of the kilowatt-hour. So if you decide to help one neighbor which hasn't any money, or you know, just no opportunity to get heat from electricity, you may decide to give it for free. So just imagine the value of it. You may have a vote, you may have a destination which is embedded, implied in the production itself. So that's, I would say, the common vision for the electricity. But there are some other applications that I'm going to list here briefly. One is all of the savings. If you are running a business, here we work for Colas, a subsidiary of Bouygues in France. When you look at the savings you may do for a factory, something when you do some proper measurement of the energy consumption, you're going to have one third, I would say, of the energy which is saved. This allows you, in fact, to do some savings, obviously, but also certificate d'économie d'énergie, all of the green tickets and all of that, some carbon also. So you may think of a new system because of blockchain, for registering all of the information and sharing that and getting new extra money from that. Another application is when you think about, there is a kind of unique thought, unique process of thought going on with photovoltaic, is that, you know, you've heard about Elon Musk and all of that. But when you think of the productivity of the solar panel, it's just a complete disaster. It's only 15%. Maximum 18%, I would say, with very expensive technology. The beauty of thermal solar panel is you've got a productivity or a yield of 80%. That means, and if you've been in Asia, you've seen probably a lot of, you know, this on the roof, but if you go all over Europe, you don't find that. So here is a neat way, in fact, just to get people having that on the roof and making some high temperature water and some low temperature to heat the houses. So you may imagine people in the same, I would say, area, being specialized in photovoltaic electricity, some other in heat to wash yourself every day, and some other for heating purpose of your house. If you push that one step further and think about blockchaining, and some proof of concept is about to begin on that, you may do that also for biogas. Biogas, it's very I would say commonly used in agricultural area. It appears to be that one company, Australian company, launched a device, a very tiny device, with 10 kilos of waste. You may do 5 cubic meters of gas per day. So think about it. that's in Ruelle Malmaison. There are some opportunities, and we are going to begin a proof of concept on that. You may do the same on waste. Waste right now are not tracked, but there are some really interesting stuff going on that. If you push the envelope a bit further, you meet all of what is called in English LETS, and in French it's CEL, Système d'échange locaux. It's an area where you've got, let's say, 1,000 people which are able to share hours, to share with their hours, you know, just to have some vegetables and all of that. You may have some people coming at home and waiting for you or helping you to do some device. People in France have been educated through, I would say, Airbnb, through Uber, to get cars shared, you know, so not to have any more a car, but just to be able to give your car and get some money from that. Blockchain, obviously, here is just it's kind of Uberization of Uber or blockchaining of Uber. You don't need at a local level, in fact, the need for that. And more than that, if you have spent a bit of hour to help your city hall, for example, you may buy some carrots. So it's just becoming crypto carrots that you can buy locally on that. If you push that one step further, you may think here it's purely, you know, just kind of truck bartering 4.0, but it's far more than that, because if you rely on the blockchain, you may have convertibility at one time or another in Bitcoin. So it means that if you need money, you may extract some money for it. If you've got some I don't know, accident in life, let's call that like that. But collectively here, if you've got a group of 1,000 people, you may be able to decide, we want to store this money. So there is a kind of pension fund at the local level which can be built just based on that. So that's something which had been asked by some community, some city hall, two in fact in France, and we are working currently on that in setting a test, a live test with around, let's say, between 500 to 1,000 people. And we have in mind to propagate this kind of thinking to 7 million people, because the operators, the energy operators working on that, has already 7 million people, and they are interested in playing this new role in this new economy. So just to put that in a nutshell, I would say there is a whole part of the neighborhoods just doing PV electricity. You've got the other one doing some high temperature thermal, so low temperature thermal, and all of the biogas. Obviously, you may think of other people. If you apply that to, and we talked about Definity, you may have the same thinking for the computers, because people can bring in their computers and just share that among the neighborhoods. And obviously here, all of that is just plugged in, what I call, it's not, obviously, it's the same mindset than token, but we're going to find here, piece of energy here for the energy production. You're going to have people specialized in producing products and services and providing services, and you may have also some all of the world lending their goods, either a car. The car usually is used 3% of the time, and you may, you know, highly increase that to 7 or 10%. And here, all of the one giving their times, you do need at least at the very beginning an operator just to put that in place, and then, you know, just after that to also comply with some other needs. The interesting stuff here is that when you look at that from an historical standpoint, when you talk to with the mayor of a city hall, the mayor, if you talk to him about a community of 1,000 people, the guy will say, well, it's about 1 million euro to run a city hall with a small city hall or neighbor like that with 1,000 people. The cost is 1 million per year. Very interestingly, if you spend, you know, each of those 1,000 people spend half an hour per day, just, I would say, 1/4 of them just lend their car, and you do this kind of microeconomics, the whole value, the whole flow of money is 1 million euro again. So it's a kind of a very interesting, you know, just balance between the two. Very official, I would say, kind of historical view of the state, view of the municipality. And on the other way, a new way to think about how to produce, how to make solidarity, how to be highly involved, a kind of new citizenship brought by blockchain. And just to put in a nutshell, I would say what we mentioned before, it's really at the very beginning, it was looking at the very beginning of the internet, all of the grow, and the blockchain currently with all of the questions like stupid or smart contracts, private or public. Obviously, we are still at the internet with TCP, IP not well defined. We are still on browser like Mosaic, Netscape hasn't appeared and all of that. And obviously, Amazon is still not there. So that's what, in a nutshell, I wanted to share with you today. Thank you.